add to their bank accounts. The losers go home empty-handed. We have 7 games headed your way today, including 4 opening round matchups. The winners will advance to the semis. The teams competing today are Markham, Kitchener, Hamilton, Oshawa, Guelph, Niagara, Toronto, and London. We're going to explain some of our unique rules as the afternoon goes on, but at this time, it is my pleasure to invite to the ice for the opening faceoff, the Adam Rep Shallow Lake Lakers. Oh, come on. Owen Sound's one of the best hockey towns in the province. Get louder for these boys, the Shallow Lake Lakers. At this time, it is my pleasure to introduce the captains of the 8 3HL Tour teams competing today. Coming out first, representing the Markham Millionaires, Brendan McLaughlin. From the Kitchener Lions, Jason Pitten. Representing the first place Hamilton Tigers, Chad Spurr. From the expansion Niagara Rapids, Wes Snell. The captain of the Toronto Bees, Jordan Reed. Representing last year's 3HL Tour champions, the London Threes, Patty Morgan. The captain of the Oshawa 88s, he currently sits second all time in games played for your Owen Sound Attack. Fans, welcome back, Marcus Carroll. And from the Guelph Brewers, a man who holds an attack record that will probably never be broken. He is the Owen Sound all-time penalty minute leader. Welcome home, Theo Peckham. So fans, or kids, if we can get you to just turn around for 1 second for a picture over there. All right, do we have a puck for the face-off? One, two, three. All right, one more time, a big round of applause for the Adam Rep Shallow Lake Lakers. We're gonna get our first 2 teams out, national anthems, and then 3-on-3 pro hockey is headed your way. Fans, while the players are getting ready, make sure you check us out on social at 3HL Tour. We're very active on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. You can also visit 3HLTour.com for highlights of today's games. And man, there are going to be a lot of them. If you've never seen 3-on-3 pro hockey, you are in for a treat. Bayshore Knockout is brought to you by Ship My Pants, Canada's pants subscription service. Ship My Pants, www.shipmypants.com. Fans, if I could please ask you to rise and gentlemen remove your hats for the playing of the national anthem.
Welcome, 3HL fans, as we're in Owen Sound today for the Bayshore Knockout, the Theo Peckham headlined event as Kitchener and Markham all take place here for our round one game. You'll notice that there are six players on each roster, two teams that prefer a shorter roster. I'll send it upstairs as we get game one underway of the tournament to Pat Gregoire, color commentator, and Anthony Regan, our play-by-play man. Guys?
Thank you very kindly, Sam. Now, we had the Shallow Lake Lakers, the Adam Rep team here, and you were saying there's a box over there in the corner at the Markham Millionaires end of the ice there, up in the corner, and their coach bought it for the family and then brothers and sisters and siblings?
Yeah, the Bear Den. So they,
nice.
It's not a bunch of little kids drinking up in the bar area. No, it's a party for them.
So. Good to know. A little bit of pizza and some cold drinks, and they get to watch some real cool action. Here we go, starting out Kitchener, right down the middle, although the ice a little too fresh there. And that spill, Peter Drikos. Fake shot there from Gubert. Trying to hook it back into Gubert now. And that could be over and back. And that's whistled down, my friend.
Yes, so if it's your first time tuning into the 3HL Tour, over and back. So much like basketball, once you gain possession in the offensive zone, you cannot go back over center. So it allows for teams to really push offense and go forward.
And we get our first shot on net, and it's turned aside.
Couple of quick notes, sorry here. Yep. Like Sam said, so Markham was supposed to have eight. Oh, here we go.
First look at the net, there they score. There we go, right off the hop. It's the Millionaires, Brendan McLaughlin, El Capitan, getting it done.
Yes, the captain with a big beard getting it done. It's his third goal of the season, but his first goal since the very first tournament up in London. He's one of these players, if Markham's going to want to be successful, he has to get offense going, and it's a good thing for them because he gets his team on the board in the first minute of play.
Okay, down the end of the ice there, there's a pair of sixes doing battle. Back towards the blue line. Man at the side of the net there, and oh, I thought he had himself an easy look at the net there, was Markham's number 27, Brock McPherson. The puck just hopped on him.
Yeah, it did. You know what you mentioned, though? This ice does look great, so I don't think it was really anything to do with some sloppy ice here.
Oh! Danced off the pipe there. I almost thought that danced around the mesh. It was such a hard shot. So a good look there. Here's a two-on-one shaping up the other way. Good save there. Tremendous save by Matt Tutton there. I got that with the shaft of the goal stick. Nifty little pass there. That exploits the triangle between the skates and the heel of the stick there. And take it to the boards, but that leaves the near side of the ice open. Here they come once again. Markham cut into the middle, shot right on. That was a low one. And having to be careful was Tutton there. And Kyle Dutra tested him. Here they come the other way. Jason Pitten taking his time. Pitten, wow, great little pass down ice. And then a nifty little move, but the puck wide of the mark. Once again, Kitchener has a look at the net. Denied. Still 1-0 in this one. Shot that was tipped on the way through, but it was a Kitchener Liars Dan Gubert who put put it a little bit wide there. He took all the steam out of that attempt. Markham with some time.
Watch out for that line for the Lions with Dutra, Pitten, and Goubert. They're all three guys that have already played on the 3HL Tour.
Okay, as Baker says, watch for me, because I'm going to do this. Nifty little pass across. They were running out of real estate there. Pass to the near side, number 91, Kevin Baker. Snaps this one home. So Baker makes it 2-0.
Hey, Kevin Baker, no stranger to scoring in this building. The former Owen Sound Attack gets his first goal since, oh my God.
Looking
almost
for
out
third.
Of, almost out of beauty there.
Yeah, McLaughlin's goal is just getting announced by Diamond Jim Lowe. Here we go, it's a turnover. Kitchener, it's Jason Pitten taking his time, finding a man all the way down ice at the offensive blue line. Shaking and baking, but you just got to sort of be a bit patient too. That's one of the things that's hard to teach here. You got to cover your man, but you've got to be patient as well, as that shot is wide of the mark, but it's recovered by Kitchener. Millionaires, of course, in green like money. That one is, goes off the end boards there. Shot, glove stop. That one goes off some skates, and we have a chance the other way. There's a great pass down ice and up to a breakaway for the guy who's opened up the scoring. McLaughlin with the silky mid puck. Hopped on him. He had a glorious op. Oh, they didn't miss on chance number two now, did they, Patty?
They certainly did not. And an absolute beauty from Kyle Dutra. He goes top shelf.
Does he ever?
On an absolute rip there. Dutra, his second goal on the 3HL Tour. He joined this team for his first tournament up in Aurora last time we were on the tour.
I bet you he's glad he did join them on the tour as well. It's 3-0 very early in this one with 2.5 to go in the first 7-minute periods for those who aren't fully aware of all the rules. And this is what can happen in 3-on-3. You start looking for goals, and then you got to defend the other way and cut back against the grain and steering that one through the legs, but wide of the mark. We got a doozy right out of the hop.
Yeah, this Markham team, they may only have 6 skaters here today, but it certainly is working for them. More volume of ice, and Tyler Shiplow, he's a guy that this Markham team missed, one of their best defensemen, if not their best defenseman, providing some offense there, almost scoring.
Okay, here's a good look there, walking around his man, but a stick on that, just Jason Pitten, it was Tyler Shiplow who did that. You mentioned what a great defensive player he is. Out to play the puck and cut it off into the corner. There is Kyle Dutra, who's got a beauty. They're 0-3, their record. They are winning this one 3-0. And dancing around his man, unable to clear. There's what I was talking about, those goaltenders getting engaged and acting like an extra player. That pass in direct in back of the net to the far side now. As Markham. They had some support coming, but here comes the other way with Kitchener Lions. Down the near side, top front, well out to cover the angles there was the netminder, Tyler Owens. Here they come now with some good speed. McCutcheon leaves that one back for number 27, McPherson. Wide of the mark. I'm not sure the goaltender knew where that one was. Now Kitchener's got it once again. Then the goaltender saying, hey, take a look at the clock there. Just under a minute to say, yeah, to play rather. Fake shot. Nobody bit on that one, but here comes the other way. There's two millionaires making their way down ice. Lovey passes to Hurston. Just wide of the mark. Sorry, I had to have a little bit of fun with the millionaires. And this one's going to go all the way the length of the ice. 38 seconds to go. Markham with it once again. This is a situation that's kind of new to them, isn't it? Going, having a 3-goal lead, a bulge like this.
Yeah, they're used to playing comeback at this point. 0-3 on the year.
Yeah.
They're a good comeback team. They haven't been able to completely, well, you know, have a comeback. Oh, geez, that's a bad play.
That was a bad play. Passing back, looking for the trailer. The trailer was on the other team. Oh, and they open up the scoring just like that, exploiting Jason Pitten. That guy plays well, doesn't he? They should make him captain.
Yeah, not the greatest play by Brendan McLaughlin, just feeding that one back, thinking he had a player there, but instead it's Jason Pitten who goes in on a breakaway. And you give a guy like Jason Pitten all that time and space, he is going to make you pay.
Is there, you know the way when you're rushing in full speed, you're coming at it, you know, you're coming in with your foot on the gas, you're looking at the goalie, you're coming in. Does it change when you've got all the time in the world for that penalty shot? You know what I mean? Because there's nobody going to catch him. So Pitten could do almost anything he wants. And sometimes I think there can be an instance there where people may overthink. I think I'll do, and then you don't get anything done. It happens to me all the time.
Absolutely. It certainly does. I mean, you see at all levels with a shootout, some players go in slow. Some players like to go wide. Some players go in quick. With our penalty shots, though, obviously you have to go in quick, because last tournament we saw Brendan McLaughlin of this Markham Millionaires team get caught by Rich Garbutt.
That's right.
But, I mean, that's a breakaway for him. So, you know, Pitton obviously had a lot of time and he cashed in.
Yes. And they're looking for some more there as that puck steered towards the net, covered up there by Tyler Owens. Owens puts the net back on its moorings there and checks it. Here they come down ice with some good foot speed here. Number 22, it's Kyle Dutcher, had a beauty of a goal. All four goals have been great ones, but Markham's have been pretty nice looking. The second two especially, or pardon me, the last two. Beautiful markers. Oh, we thought there was gonna be a huge collision there. I was waiting for the hit that didn't come. And there is hitting in this league, of course, but you have to pick your spots because you can hit all you want and get caught out of position. 6 minutes and 17 seconds to go here in period number two. So plenty of time remaining in this one, but you've got to be quick if you're Kitchener. You're down by a pair of goals, Pat.
Yeah, you have to. There has to be some urgency, and of course you don't want to force the issue too much because that's where you see even a play is going the other way. But when you're down a couple of goals, you got to get going. But 6 minutes here, it's absolutely nothing in the 3HL.
Towards the front of the net there. That was a weak attempt there off the stick of the Kitchener's Trent Hawk, who carried the puck. So Markham takes over. And you're going to better believe that Markham's going to want to try and chew up as much of the clock as they can. And here they come once again. Stick chopped out of the hands of the player. That should be a penalty, I think, with chasers. A win-well shot. No arms up in the... No, indeed, but I'd like to talk to Peter Drikos about whether or not he was happy with his stick flying up in the air.
Markham Millionaires looking for their first win since March 5th, 2017, where they won at the 3HL Guelph Games last year. So this could be very, very big for them, picking up a win in almost a full year.
Yes. They are 0-3 this year so far, so they've traveled a long way, and they do not intend on going home with a little something in the form of a check.
Absolutely not. A lot of these guys, they might be...
Oh, what a filthy tip in front that was.
I was going to say, a lot of these guys, they might be playing for Markham, but a good chunk of their team comes from Brampton. So
right.
That still is a little bit of a hike, what, up the 410 there. So
410, then the 10, and then as my GPS said, keep driving until you lose your mind, and then you're another half an hour past that.
Nice save. Yeah,
lovely stop indeed. If you pass the tree line, yeah, if your water starts filling up in your car, put it in reverse. Oh, it's glorious country. Went driving through the Niagara Escarpment and Owen Sound. Part of that is there's a great stop as well. Some beautiful waterfalls as well. Not just Hamilton, the city of waterfalls. There's a lot of them. Walters Falls is just nearby here, actually. I saw two signs for it on the way north. And here they come. Markham looking to be... Be careful, though. You can't go back over center. They pass it over to the far side. They got some time. I thought there was going to be a fake shot, actually. Now here comes Kitchener. They've got the puck. Down to 4 minutes even to go in this one. So 4 minutes in which to score two goals to tie this one. Wow, we got a bit of a miscue out there as Tyler Owens thought he had more time and space to play the puck. He squeezes the legs together to make sure that one doesn't get through as Kitchener's testing now. There's a shot right on that off the stick of Jason Pitton. Into the corner it goes. Markham looks like they're content just to sort of slow things down a little. Doesn't it look like it? Oh, so we've got a player tripping on the skates of another one. There was nothing ill-mannered about that. There's a shot, shoulder stop there by Matt Tutton. How's Tutton doing, by the way, so far?
You know, Tutton's looked pretty strong in his first appearance in the 3HL Tour. I'd say at least two of those goals were absolute snipes, and he had no business saving that. So good job on him.
Yeah, for sure. And now it's Kitchener who are looking to play the clock. Down to 3 minutes and 13 seconds to go in this one. Time is of the essence. There's a shot. It was blocked on the way through. May have hit his own teammate there. That one's tested upstairs as Tyler Owens lifts his shoulder and knocks that one into the mesh. That was a hurry-up face-off, so Markham controls off the draw and taking their time, making their way down ice is Kyle McCutcheon. McCutcheon had a little man playing pick there. It was Tyler Shiplow. Shiplow in front of the net! Oh, good stop by Matt Tutton. You mentioned he shouldn't have had any business stopping that one. He needed to stop to make sure his team's still in this. Down to 2:36 to go now in this one. In back of the net. Now, we saw some overtime when we were in Oshawa. We saw it a few times, actually,
yes,
didn't we?
Yeah, it was OT filled. We'll have to see today if there will be some more OT games. But as I mentioned, Markham looking for their first win in almost a full year, and it would also be their second win ever. They just finished with one win last year, finishing in last place.
Oh, what a pass out front. And I think there was one too many moves. And then, another one. And then the backhand's just wide of the mark. That was crazy action right there. And the fans are loving it. Here's a turnover once again as it was a great pass out front. Oh, he cannot beat Matt Tutton. Gets the pad down. Boy, we've had a few highlights already, pal.
Unbelievable.
The old commercial, it's worth the drive to Acton. Whoa, it's worth the drive to Owen Sound. That one changed direction on the way through. Might take a while to get here, but we're so glad that you're with us as well. Great a crowd here at a terrific facility where the Owen Sound Attack ply their trade. Kitchener now trying to apply some pressure. That went up and over. Now to a minute 32 to go now. A hurry-up face-off. It's scrambled to the near side. Checking the shoulder now is Kitchener's player, number six, I believe that was. No, pardon me, that's eight. That's Dan Guibert. He's got it back. Guibert shot. He was looking blocker side upstairs. Denied by the netminder. Kitchener with all the pressure in the world with a minute 15, though. As long as they keep applying pressure, they have a good opportunity. If this puck is turned over, you might as well turn out the lights. There's a great shot. What a terrific stop that was. Tyler Owens came across and sealed the area tight to the pipe. They got a man down ice. Can they find him? Yes, they do. Here we go. Number 91 all alone. Oh, and he tucked it through the five hole there. Kevin Baker seals the deal with 52.8.
The former Owen Sound Attack just with some nifty mitts there and just gets Tutton's legs open enough so he can slide that one through the wickets. And I think that's all she wrote there. 4-1 with 50 seconds to go.
Kitchener have two wins and three losses. They're going to go to 2-4, barring a miracle comeback in this one. But Kitchener is going to go down to 40 seconds. They may have a goal. That's for the ride back home, perhaps. Christmas got an assist on that last goal. So it's still Christmas. Oh, and coming out to play that was the netminder Tutton. That was one of those foot races. That reminds me of Rich Wigmore coming way out. Was that that time?
Yes.
You said, speaking of ship my pants. I remember that line.
Was
I was laughing for about 10 minutes after that one. In back of the net, down to 13 seconds to go. They try and tuck one off the goalie, and they do. Gretzky-esque.
There it is. That's the one you're talking for the ride home. But it's not only just for the ride home. It's for standings as
yes.
well. Like you mentioned, goals for and against.
Yes.
With teams that are tied, you know, with winning percentage,
right.
those goals for and against make a difference. Last year we saw three teams, all with the same winning percentage, and goals against average was the tiebreaker.
That
and that's
was.
The difference between being eighth and sixth.
Well, it's a 4-2 final, and the Markham Millionaires are starting to live up to that moniker, my friend, as they pick up their first win of the 2017-2018 3HL Tour. Took them to Owen Sound to get there, but I'm pretty sure they're here to stay for a while.
Yes, and it took them almost a full calendar year. Like
that's
I said,
true.
March 5th, 2017, the last time the Markham Millionaires cashed in a check. Great to see them pick up their first win of this tour season. I mentioned it before, the all sports market, talking all about, you know, investing in certain teams in the 3HL. Well, this is one team I would think about putting my money in because I think their stock is going to rise and rise and rise and rise. And someone who has been rising up the ranks of the 3HL Tour is Kyle Dutra. And it looks like Sam McDade is going to be joined alongside number 22 of the Markham Millionaires. There you go.
Thanks, guys. Alongside Brock McPherson, who had the game in the first win for the Markham Millionaires and two goals for you. So what was working out there on the ice for you today?
I don't know. I just tried to keep it simple today. I know we wanted to get our first win under our belt, so we just stuck to defense and then the offense came. So it's a lot of fun today.
I know the Kitchener Lions like prefer you guys.
Oh, we're definitely feeling it. I know we've never played two games in one day, but it'll be interesting. But I'm glad we got the first one out of the way.
You guys are starting your conditioning program today. Now you guys face the winners of Hamilton, Oshawa, who are warming up right now. Is there a preference of who you would like to face?
I don't know. It's a Saturday. You got to play hockey, and there's no better sport in the world. So.
Thanks so much.
Thanks a lot.
I'll send it back upstairs to you, Pat and Anthony.